the divine blessings that guide each of us on this journey.
As we move forward, we come to a very special part of today's celebration, the lighting of the diya. This simple yet powerful act symbolizes the light of wisdom, unity, and the unwavering hope that education brings. In our Don Bosco family, this light represents our shared mission to nurture young minds and hearts and to inspire each child to grow in knowledge, character, and compassion.
For this meaningful moment, we are honored to invite esteemed individuals to come forward and light the diyas.
First, we invite His Grace, Most Reverend Archbishop John Mulachira, the Archbishop of Guwahati, whose presence and blessing fills this occasion with grace and inspiration.
From the academic world, we invite Dr. Anuradha Chaudhary, the esteemed principal of Lamding College.
Next, we call upon Reverend Father Joshi, who is not only a spiritual guide, but also our dedicated principal, leading Don Bosco High School with his wisdom and vision. Accompanying him, we welcome Sister Stella, our compassionate and caring headmistress, whose guidance has lighted the way of each student in our school community.
Representing of all our parents, whose love, support and encouragement are the foundation of our students' achievement, we invite Mrs. Sushmita Bhumi. Let us welcome our honored guests for another significant moment, that is the hoisting of the Jubilee flag. This flag serves as a strength, achievement and enduring spirit that makes Don Bosco School a place of joy and peace. As we celebrate this milestone, this flag serves as our commitment towards excellence, growth and community.
For this special moment, we invite our Most Reverend Archbishop John Mulachira, who graces this celebration with his blessings. Joining him is Father Joshi, our dedicated principal, along with other esteemed guests. Together, they will raise this flag to inaugurate the Golden Jubilee Year of the Don Bosco High School Lamding. Let us welcome our honored guest to the flagpole for the hoisting of the Jubilee flag. Thank you.
It truly captured the spirit of Feel at Home, the defiance of our Don Bosco community.
Now, it is my honor to invite Father Joshi, our respected principal, to deliver the welcome speech. Father Joshi has been a guiding force in our school, inspiring both students and staff with his vision, dedication, and unwavering support. His leadership has played a pivotal role in shaping the values and excellence we strive at Don Bosco School.
So, let us give a warm round of applause to welcome Father Joshi to the stage.
It is my great honor and pleasure to welcome all of you to the second day of annual day cum Parents Day celebration of Don Bosco High School Lundy. It is a time to celebrate the achievements and milestones of the past years. It is an opportunity to recognize the hard work, dedication and the talents of our students and staff. Today we come together as a family to reflect on our progress, celebrate our success and to look forward to the future with hope and enthusiasm. There is also another reason for us to celebrate, because DBS Lumding reaches by 2025 his historical mark, 50 years of its existence. We are entering into the golden jubilee of Don Bosco High School Lumding. Don Bosco High School is a unit of the Catholic Church Lumding, based on Christ values, established and administered and owned by the Archdiocese of Guwahati and our beloved Archbishop John Moolachara as his president. For last 49 years, DBS Lumding has been transforming the life of many young minds, mainly through education and other social activities, irrespective of caste, creed, languages, culture and religion. I am very much sure that some of the parents who are present here today are the fruits of DBS Lumding. We have started our celebration yesterday. The presence of Mrs. Sibu Misra, MLA, 64 LAC Lumding, Mr. Prem Ranjan Kumar, DRM, Lumding Division, Mr. Shashadhar Kalida, OC, Lumding Police Station, have made yesterday's program so unique and meaningful. Before we begin today's program, I would like to extend my warm welcome and a heartfelt thanks to our esteemed chief guest, Most Reverend John Moolachara, the Archbishop of Guwahati, for gracing us with your presence today. Your grace, you are so dear to Don Bosco High School, Lumding. Your presence with us today shows that your love, concern and care for Bostonian family. Your timely intervention and support helped DBS to grow and updates itself for the betterment of the students here. On behalf of entire students, staff and parents, I would like to express my heartfelt gratitude to you, dear Grace, for your valuable presence here with us today. Now, I would like to call the students of class 5 along with Ms. Redna Day to welcome our chief guest, beloved Archbishop John Mulachera, with Assamese gamosa, japi and bouquet of flowers. Let us give a huge round of applause. I also take this opportunity to welcome our guest of honor, the prominent person in Lumding in the field of education and molding the life of the youngsters, both boys and girls, that is none other than Dr. Aniradha Chaudhary, the principal of Lumding College. Thank you, ma'am, for your valuable presence with us today, as well as accepting our invitation for this day. Now, I would like to call the students of class 5 along with Ms. Amrita to welcome our guest of honor, Dr. Aniradha Chaudhary, with Assamese gamosa, japi and bouquet of flowers. Let us give a big round of applause. Happy to welcome Sir Madhav Gope, CRCC, Cluster Resource Center Coordinator, Lumding Railway City Cluster, Department of School Education. Sir is not new face to the DBS family. Sir was working here as a teaching staff. Dear Sir Madhav, we are very much happy to have you today with us. I would like to call the students of class 7 together with Ms. Seema to welcome Sir Madhav Gope. Privilege to welcome all the fathers, sisters, friends and other well wishers.
Thank you, Father Joshi, for a uplifting welcome speech. It truly resonates with the spirit of unity and growth we celebrate today.
As we progress with our program, it is my distinct honor to invite Sister Stella, our dedicated headmistress, to present the school report.
Sister Stella has been a pillar of strength and guidance at Don Bosco School, ensuring that our students not only receive a quality education, but also the moral support they need to thrive.
So please join me in giving a warm welcome to invite Sister Stella to the stage.
Dream deep, for every dream leads to the purpose of a delightful and dignified human life. A pleasant good afternoon and an affectionate welcome to each and every one of you to this solemnity of this evening's celebration. Education forms and transforms for the fullness of life. I believe this is the kernel of education. DBS pedagogy is crystal clear to unite the learners with its thrust, education, key to the fullness of life. Today, what we need is a humanized education that urges everyone to transform, celebrate, and excel with the tangibles of fraternal humanism. Today we celebrate not only our students' achievements, but also the rich legacy of social capital of DBS unfolded for the last 50 years, leading to the threshold of its golden jubilee. To mark this blissful day, we are honored to have with us our chief guest, His Grace Most Reverend Archbishop John Mulachira, the Archbishop of Guwahati, Dr. Anuradha Chowdhury, Principal London College, Sir Madhav Gop, CRCC London, distinguished guests, fathers and sisters, our Principal Father Joshi, and dear parents and students. This year has been filled with growth, innovation, and a renewed focus on academic and personal development. And I am thrilled to present our collective accomplishment to you. New administration. May 30th, 2023 was a day of mixed feelings of farewell and welcome. We bid farewell to Father Raj Kapoor, the then principal, Sister Sumita, the headmistress, Sister Teresa Lagado, and Sister Teresa Monica. We welcomed Father Joshi as our new principal, alongside myself, Sister Stella, as headmistress, Sister Sunita Edith, the primary in charge, and Sister Margaret, the KG in charge. Sister Sunita Edith, who previously managed the primary section, was transferred by June 2024 and replaced by Sister Mary Guite. While Sister Marilyn took over the KG section from Sister Margaret. Their leadership has inspired our school community and fostered a culture of excellence. Additionally, we relocated the KG section to the high school building, creating a more cohesive environment for our youngest students and enhancing collaboration among staff. Strength of the school. DBS London stands tall with 1,394 students, supported by 46 teachers and 15 non-teaching staff. This year, we welcomed several new staff members, strengthening our faculty. We also bid farewell to Mrs. Amarjit Kaur upon her retirement, and currently we have two teachers on medical leave. Academic results for Matric Exam 2023-24. Our students achieved outstanding results in the Matric examinations, showcasing their dedication, hard work. Here is the summary of the results. Total students appeared 75. Total students passed 75. 100% pass rate with 12 distinctions, 34 star marks, 38 first divisions, and only one second division. subject specific achievements, full marks, 100 upon 100 in advanced mathematics for 2 students and computer science 1 student. Letter marks, SMEs 4 students, Hindi 5 students, English 65 students, Mathematics 18 students, Science 43 students, Social Science 50 students, Computer Science 44 students, and Advanced Mathematics 9 students. Mr. Ankit Day achieved the highest aggregate marks of 570, scoring an impressive 95%. These remarkable achievements reflect the dedication and hard work of our students and the unwavering support of management, staff and parents. Developments and improvements. This year, we made significant enhancements to improve our school's infrastructure, learning environment, and overall students' experience. We have established a new office for the headmistress to streamline administrative functions and improve communication. We installed CCTV cameras throughout the campus to enhance safety for students and staff. Digital classrooms have been introduced for the students of class 9 and 10, providing and engaging interactive learning experiences. We installed sound boxes in each classroom, allowing students to hear important announcements, prayers, and other essential messages throughout the day. A new school gate and security room has been established to improve the campus security. An additional school bus has been added to meet the transportation need of our students. Digital and educational initiatives. To further enhance communication and streamline learning processes, we have implemented several digital tools and academic improvements. To begin the day with the intercom assembly, which include morning prayer, news bulletin, thought of the day, national anthem, and a brief meditation. This initiative fosters unity and positive vibe to begin each day well. Special open assemblies are organized on every Thursday, offering a platform for students to showcase their talents and for the school to celebrate their achievements. Students now receive digital mark sheets, allowing easy access to their academic records at any time. We have introduced a digital attendance system for both students and teachers, ensuring real-time and accurate attendance tracking. A new school app has been launched, providing parents with essential information, including their child's academic progress, attendance records, school notices, event updates, and more. We have introduced EI, online assessments, for classes 9 and 10 to prepare students for board exams, enhancing their readiness for future challenges. Additional initiatives and programs. We organized various activities and improvements to enrich our school community. We introduced the school band, where students received training in instrumental music from Mr. Raghavan from Kerala. The science exhibition on May 17, 2024 showcased students' creativity and innovation, encouraging a passion for scientific inquiry. we held a vibrant sports and cultural week, promoting teamwork, sportsmanship, and artistic expression among students. A seminar on stress management and study habits was organized for students, equipping them with techniques to manage academic pressures and develop effective study habits. A seminar focused on classroom management and teaching skills was conducted, providing teachers with valuable strategies to enhance their effectiveness in the classroom. A picnic for teachers was organized for fun and relaxation, team spirit, and it strengthened the bonds among the staff members. We have class-wise parents meeting from KG1 to class 10 to encourage personalized discussions regarding each student's progress, goals, and achievements. Abacus Learning has been introduced for students from KG1 to class 5, enhancing their mental maths and problem-solving abilities. New toilet facilities for girls to ensure their comfort and hygiene at school. New hand wash facilities for being provided for students after tiffin, promoting good hygienic practices. Installed filtered drinking water facilities separately for students and staff, ensuring access for safe drinking water for everyone in the campus. Development of a new playground for the students for their physical education and relaxation. In conclusion, I extend my heartfelt gratitude to Father Joshi, our principal, dedicated leadership of sisters, committed teachers, supportive parents, and hardworking students. Together, we are building a caring and progressive learning environment that prepares our students to enjoy fullness of life in the teaching-learning process. Thank you for your ongoing trust, support, and collaboration. Let us continue to work together towards excellence in the upcoming years. Our confident and multi-talented students are ready to celebrate their learning perfections with grace and elegance. Let us all feel proud of them. Thank you. Long live DBS Lumding.
Truly inspires us all.
As we continue our celebration today, it's my great pleasure to invite Mrs. Sushmita Bhoumik, who has been not just a dedicated parent, but also an integral part of our Don Bosco school family.
Let us warmly welcome Mrs. Sushmita Bhoumik to the stage and show our appreciation for the vital role that she and all the parents play in our community.
At first, a very happy and warm evening to everybody present here.
For your thoughtful words and for representing the vital role of parents in our community.
Now, we have the distinct honor of welcoming our esteemed guest of honor, Dr. Anuradha Chaudhary, the principal of Lumding College. She has been a dedicated advocate for education and community development.
As a leader in our community, she understands the challenges and opportunities that lie within our education system.
Please join us in giving a warm welcome to our honored guest, Dr. Anuradha Chaudhary, as she takes the stage to share her vision and insights with us.
नमस्कार
A very good afternoon to all of you present here. Honorable chief guest of today's program, Most Reverend John Mulchira, the Archbishop of Guwahati. Respected Principal Don Bosco High School, Headmistress, respected Headmistress Don Bosco High School, all the esteemed guests seated in front of me, all the fathers and mothers present here, dear parents, guardians, and the most lovely students. I, on behalf of myself and the entire Lambing College fraternity, extend my heartiest thanks and gratitude to all of you, particularly the school management, for inviting me on this prestigious occasion. It is a rare opportunity for me to be a part of such a wonderful program. It is a proud privilege and a matter of great pleasure to address such an august gathering on such a special and auspicious day, the day of the parents, the day of the entire school fraternity. At the end of an academic year, this day comes to ruminate over the year-long activities accomplished by the school fraternity successfully, to review and cherish precious memories to be capitalized for better and more vibrant school days with innovative endeavors to be undertaken in the time to come. This day is special not only for the students but for the parents too, because in the life of a student, along with the teachers, the vital role played by the parents is beyond any question. And I believe that it is a joint venture of the school, parents, guardians, and the students as such. Thus, my warm wishes to all the parents on this special day of yours, and also the students and the entire school. It's a day of celebration and joy, as well as a day of introspection and future planning. It is a day of great importance for students, staff, faculty members, parents, a time to reflect on the year's accomplishments and to look forward to the future with more enthusiasm. Dear students and the school fraternity, let me go back to my past a little bit, because as I am standing right now on this sacred soil of renowned Don Bosco High School, Lambing, I feel rather nostalgic for the fact that I have very deep relationships with the Don Bosco School, Convent School at Hafelong. My father, being a professor of English in Hafelong Government College and a renowned homeopath, he had a very good relation with the fathers, or the respected fathers of the Don Bosco School, Mother Superior of Convent School. And we had very friendly, my father had a very friendly relationship with all of them. So I am going back at least 20 to 25 years back while I am standing over here, because though I didn't study in either of these two schools, but they always blessed me. And I still remember when I was appearing in matric examination, the mother superiors and father superiors, when they went to the center to bless their students, they blessed me too. So I can't forget those precious memories associated with the Don Bosco School and the Convent School, St. Agnes School, Hafelong. So
So dear students, let me tell you that you are very precious for all of us. Because you are now buds and you are going to be transformed into fully bloomed flowers very soon. And you will have to take lots of responsibilities for the society. So you are the future pillars of the nation. And you know what?